South Africa, ikamalami usimhlobo Simphiwe Ngema, and today we are in Midrand. We are here to learn more about the Muslim culture. You know, we are a rainbow nation and we are going to learn about every culture. So, asambeni, niyobona nami.
Muslim is an Arabic word meaning one who submits. The Muslim faith is also known as Islamic. The Muslim people are located all over the world, with the largest population being in Indonesia, South Asia, the Middle East, and North Africa. Although the Muslim culture is very vibrant, they still follow a strict code of laws and customs prescribed in their holy book, the Quran.
Because lo mlenze lo kumele ubone ubani umuntu wami kuphela nizwile bafethu khona manje ngino Abraham uzosibonisa ukuthi izandla zigeza kanjani no Ali ukhona futhi mara siboneni.
Sir, welcome to our show. Could you please show us how we wash our hands?
Okay, well, this is, we call it ablution, wudu in Arabic term. So Mr. Ali, he will show us how to make wudu.
Is there a specific symbolism of washing your hand?
Just clean, one's clean themselves before each and every prayer. Oh, and also prayer. Before reading Quran, also we do need to make ablution. So anything we do, and also ladies do the same thing. Okay. No discrimination.
In order to cleanse themselves for prayer, the Muslim perform wudu, which is a ritual washing. They do this first by calling the name of God, and then they wash the right and the left hand three times. Like Prophet Muhammad said, cleanliness is half of faith.
Yes. And the mouth.
Well, guys, there you have it. Nibonile ukuthi bawasha kanjani. Bathi kumele washe izandla zakho and all the places that you use the most before singena, because this is indeed a sacred place. So, khona manje ngifuna ukuthi bangibonise ukuthi le ndawo lena kuthandazwapi nokuthi kwenzakalani.
Sir, could you please take us through the whole place?
Please.
Thank you.
The way we pray inside the mosque, it's barefoot, no shoes, and also we bow down and we put our forehead on the ground, on the carpet, so it needs to be clean and hygiene. That's why we need to take our shoes off also. We don't bring any dirt inside the mosque.
Wow! You!
Our mosque called Nizamiya Mosque. You could say there are few meanings of Nizamiya, but it means well organized.
Could you please explain this structure?
This one called place for Mu'addin. Mu'addin is the one who calls people to prayer. Before each and every prayer, there is a specific kind of calling prayer. It's not, I don't want to call it like singing, but it's an alert for the people that the prayer time is near. So the Mu'addin is a title. He goes up and calls people to prayer. This one is called Mimbar. This is for the sermon, Friday sermons, and we use it once in a week. An imam stands there behind the microphone and gives sermon. Here in South Africa, mostly it takes maybe 10 to 15 minutes, sometimes 20 minutes.
You can see there's a lot of artwork. Could you please tell me the meaning of it?
So there are some verses from the Quran, also some supplications in different places. So it may take a lot of time if I explain it to them, but okay. Briefly I want to mention there are 99 attributes of God. In Islam, when we believe in one God, we believe in oneness of God. And also it comes believing in God comes with package. Interesting thing happened when they put this big lightning, big chandelier, the outer circle, which is this circle, the number of the globes came out 99, matching the number of God's attributes. In other words, for each attribute, there is one globe. dedicated globe. This one called mihrab, you see the imam stands like this and facing Mecca, and people are lining up behind the imams. You see the each section is for line up for one goal. People, they do line up behind the imam. Imam must be in the front.
Oh, those are really small steps, and that's a very small chair.
This one is called kursi. Kursi means chair. And we do have literally chair inside. So we do sit and face the congregation and give advice, usually pre-prayer on Friday.
There are specific people that are allocated to sit here and give the lecture.
The one who conducts the service that day, mostly he is the one who gives lecture.
Mm. Do women ever conduct a service?
No.
Okay. No,
they do listen.
Okay, is there a specific reason?
The leadership in prayer, it's allocated for men.
There you have it, guys. Sibonile ukuthi benza kanjani izinto lana nokuthi building yabo yinhle kanjani. At least sengiyazi ukuthi kuculwa kuphi nayazi le sound lela bachanta khona. Sengiyazi ukuthi iphuma kuphi. I hope you guys enjoyed this part of the show, but we are still here. Isiko, let's go.
Muslims take a very high regard in their clothing. A garment known as a burqa, which means veil or curtain, is worn by women in the Islamic culture to cover mostly their face and revealing only their eyes.
In every culture, there are rules and customs when it comes to initiation or just being a woman. To tell us more about this, we have Ma'am. Ma'am, how are you?
Good morning. I'm fine, thank you.
What is the role of a Muslim woman in the Muslim community?
Muslim women have a really important role in the society, in the community, as Muslim women. However, this would depend a lot from culture to culture, from tradition to tradition. In the past, Muslim women were in the forefront of battlefields. They were in the forefront of nursing people. They had really important roles to play. Even today, you know, there are still very traditional Muslim families where women have chosen roles to be domesticated, and they're mostly in the domestic sphere. However, there are also those women who have gone out, they're educating themselves, and they're taking leading roles in promoting Islam, in the progression of Islam, in the progression of women.
What is the process from being that girl that wears whatever she wants to wear to being the girl that dresses and covers her hair?
Young girls who haven't reached the age of puberty yet are free to dress as they like. Okay. But once you reach puberty, then it's compulsory for you to have your head covered, you know, to have loose garments on, your arms are covered. The basic covering for a Muslim woman is your whole body has to be covered. The only parts that are exposed are the hands, the feet and the face. We also have another system where our kids go to an afternoon class or afternoon school where they are being taught about the religion, the requirements, and they live it in their homes. They see their mums, they see their cousins. Mm. So by the time this transition comes, they are already prepared for it. They do know that, you know, I am now of a certain age and I need to dress in a certain way.
Could you please tell me how I am dressed? Is it appropriate?
Very appropriate. I'm quite impressed with you.
Is there any specific reason why we have to cover the hair?
The Muslim woman's covering is a lot to do with her modesty. Mm. It's about modesty. It's about humility. Mm. A lot of the Muslim girls today are quite fashionable within the confines of the covering. Mm. So, I mean, you can have a look at me as well. You probably thought one would need to wear black and so on. Yeah. I am completely covered, but I mean, God loves beauty. Mm. You can find beauty in your dressing as well. It doesn't have to be morbid and depressing. And you don't want to flaunt your beauty everywhere else. Your beauty would be reserved for the people nearest and dearest to you. These are the people that you sort of relax in front of. But once you go out, you preserve this. You know, you preserve your beauty for the people who are close to you. It is so liberating. When you're walking out there, you just know somehow within yourself, there's a level of safety. There's a feeling of safety. You're not attracting anybody towards you, and you are free to go out doing what you need to do.
Wow, beautiful. Thank you very much. Thank
you.
Well, nizwele bafethu ukuthi research yami ngishayile, ngishayile. Ngiyangibona musu ukuthi ninjani. Beg. Uyayibona? Well, anyway, sisazofunda more about the Muslim culture. We are learning about the Muslim culture. Sifuna ukwazi ukuthi bona bacula kanjani, and I'm here with a young man ozongitshela kahle ukuthi what kind of music do they sing and do they ever turn up? Hello, welcome to Isiko.
Okay, thank you for having me.
Please tell me who you are and what you do.
My name is Muhammad Zahuddin Zardar. I'm 19. I recently completed my hibs. It's where you memorize the entire Quran off by memory. I completed last year. Currently, this year I was doing like revision of my Quran.
The Muslim music, is it something that you chose to do, or is it something that is religious for you?
Well, you see, you can't really term it music. You see, it's okay. Like it's reciting the words of Allah, the God. You see, so it's not like music or anything. Although Islam does have room for many melody and symphony and things like that there. Mm-hmm. But yeah, basically, so it's just like reciting the words of Allah in a melodious tune.
Do your friends listen to you when you recite, and what do they think of it?
They do, and they're very supportive, you know. And well, obviously, look, most of my friends are Muslim, you see. So they know what it is.
Muslims don't dance, right?
Yes, yes, no, they don't.
So I want to know, is there any type of music that you listen to?
I don't listen to.
Is it because of your religion, or is it a choice that?
Well, look, like the thing is, the household that I was brought up in. But myself, I grew up like that, so I don't really have an interest in that. I know people like get like this when they listen to music, they get like this feeling, goosebumps and things like that. They,
and it's the same. For
it's
you.
The same thing. I get like when I listen to reciting, they call it kirat. Yes. You see, kirat. Yeah. People are singing. You see. So when I listen to it, it's the same thing for me.
Do you have female friends?
I don't really intermingle or meet girls or anything like that.
So there's no dating.
There's no dating. My father is very strict, and my father is an imam.
Okay.
So my father is very strict. So if he must find out anything like that, he'll be very upset with me.
You are clearly proud of where you come from and your religion.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for sitting with me and having this chat.
Wassama.
Today we are exploring the Muslim culture, and I want to know about the circumcision. In every culture we do circumcise, and it is very important. But I have someone here who will tell us more about that. Good day and welcome to Isiko. Please tell me who you are and what you do.
Well, I'm Dr. Ismail Mitha. I'm a general practitioner who practices on the East Rand. I've been in practice for over 20 years, and I've been doing circumcisions for that amount of time.
Wow.
You know, during the winter season, we do close on to 40, maybe 50 circumcisions per day. I perform circumcisions across the cultural groups.
Wow.
And religious groupings as well.
In the Muslim religion, do you have to have a Muslim doctor to do the circumcision?
Not at all.
Is it?
Not at all. Anyone can perform the circumcision, preferably a doctor.
And is there a specific age maybe for the initiation?
We would encourage parents to circumcise their children as young as possible. The complication rate amongst the younger kids is a lot less. The memory of the circumcision is obviously a lot less as well. And the healing time in the younger kids is obviously incredibly faster. So we encourage it in the very early ages. And in fact, there's Circumcisions are performed 1 week after birth.
So are there any ceremonies prior to the circumcision or after?
Islam is a very non-ceremonious religion as such. So there's no ceremony or rite of passage ceremony when it comes to circumcisions. There's no real ceremony for anything in Islam, in the religion, apart from when you get married.
Okay.
But, you know, the thing is, what marks a boy turning into an adult male? What we call, the term that we use is baligh, that is, become of age. Mm. And then all the five fundamentals of Islam become compulsory on him. That is, he needs to pray five times a day, he needs to perform the Hajj. And so the five, the fundamentals have come into play once he reaches adulthood. So the responsibility of adulthood falls on him once he starts to sprout a beard, a few hairs, that is, a moustache, deepening of the voice, and maybe develops pubic and axillary hair. And those are basically the signs that a boy has transitioned into adulthood.
No celebration.
There's no celebration. There's no bar mitzvah like in the Jewish culture. There's none of that. There's no slaughtering of an animal or any of that. There's no ceremony at all. Female circumcisions come up a lot. A perception or a misconception that Muslims perform female circumcisions. Yeah. But nowhere is it sort of ordained or prescribed.
Thank you very much for clearing that up. Well, guys, there you have it. I've learned a lot about the Muslim culture and I still want to learn more. But we have to go to a break right now. And you're still watching Isiko. So don't go away because you are going to miss a lot. See you after the break.
Fortsburg is a residential suburb located in Johannesburg, which also houses numerous shops and factories. It carries a rich Muslim culture that can be seen in the boldly colored fabrics and spicy bargain stalls that fill the streets.
Muslims around the world follow the Islamic religion, which means they also have to follow their dietary laws and teachings. What is the difference between halal and haram? And umuntu ozosifundisa ngakho konke lokho kula ngaphakathi. So asambeni siyomuzwa ukuthi uthini. Sengingenile ngaphakathi mara kunenkinga eyi-1 abafuna ukuthi ngene kitchen mhlawumbe bacabanga ukuthi ngizotshontsha ispice namarecipe wakhona angazi mara umuntu ozongi-explainela kahle ukuthi why kungamelanga ngene kitchen ula uhleli nami. Good day, sir.
How are you?
I'm good and you? Could you please tell me who you are and tell me why I'm not allowed to go into the kitchen?
Actually, we don't deny, but the problem is you came in the early in the morning, this time they're still cleaning on that side. But hopefully you will enjoy our food, because we prepare our food always freshly, and this is the halal restaurant. The people, they like the halal food because it is guaranteed that this is the hygienic food. Sometimes people are asking the question about what is the halal and what is not non-halal. You know, we the Muslim people, we are following our highest religious book, that one we call Holy Quran. That Quran, they gave us the guideline about which is permissible to eat, which is not permissible to eat.
I see you've got a lot of dishes prepared here. Could you please just explain some of the dishes that are here?
This is the butter chicken.
Okay.
This is the one of the richest foods, whatever we are selling in South Africa. Mostly this is the very common food.
It's quite good.
Thank you.
So what is the recipe for this one? Are you not going to give it away?
No, the thing is, normal recipe I can give you that one. It's based on sliced chicken, mix it the butter, mix it the creamy sauce there. Then we come to the second one, this is the shik kebab. That's the grilled item. This grilled item is the chicken meats inside with the spicy inside. We got 168 items food in this restaurant.
Different recipes, 168.
You know, sometimes we see the people, they're coming very far, they want to enjoy our food. Because once they enjoyed it, they can't forget that one. If they pass by this side, they come and enjoy our food. That one is the baby chicken, it's a grill item there.
Okay.
And then if we go for this one, there's the chicken munsuria. And the last one, that one is there, That one is the grilled prawns.
What is the famous dish out of all of this?
Most common dish is the biryani. Ah. And then it goes to the fried rice, then goes to the naans and the grilled chickens.
Okay.
So this baby chicken is the one of the best common things in South Africa because of that grilling system and the spicy what we're using there and the taste is very big different in the other restaurant. So you can check, you can test which one is the best according to you. But in our side, we always think the biryani and the mutton dishes, we have some English dishes, and very common in the English dishes is the butter chicken.
There you have it. We have come to the end of our episode. Ningakhohlwa ukuthi nisibukele futhi next week, same time, same place. And don't forget to talk to us on Facebook and Twitter. On Facebook, it's at Isiko ETV. And on Twitter, it is at Isiko_ETV. From me, na usim Chauke, usim Zonke, usim everything. Ngithi ngizonibona next week. Bye.